Hospice and Palliative Care Center cares for thousands of patients and their families every year. No two patients are alike, and we strive to meet our patients where they are, medically, emotionally, socially, and spiritually, wherever they call home. We have also made a commitment to care for every person in need of our care, regardless of their ability to pay. Our generous supporters have helped make that possible. This story is about many things: community collaboration, a trusted referral partner, a compassionate team of caregivers, the impact of our generous community of donors. And most importantly, it's the story about a man who, against many odds, was met with compassion, respect, quality care, and a peaceful, dignified end of life. It all started with a referral from one of our healthcare partners.
His medical diagnosis with hospice was cancer, and it was a stage 4 cancer. He was told there was nothing else they can do. So he was sent home with pain medication. He also had a history of high blood pressure that wasn't treated throughout the years because he just wasn't really in the system.
So the referral came from Novant Health. It came through our referral department. It was when complex cases are identified, they'll come across my desk for review. It was identified as a complex case because we'll refer to him as Mr. Jeffries, because this gentleman lived in a cemetery and part of his time was also spent at a car dealership. So he was somewhat transient, if you will.
He was homeless by choice. And one of the ways he would help make money, he would go help out at this car dealership. Since he got sick, he was able to stay in a back office for a little while, but he wanted to get back to the cemetery.
When I found out about this gentleman, I was not too keen. My biggest concern is that he was living in the bathroom in the cemetery. So the logistics involved, how are our nurses going to see them? I know my nursing staff is not going to go to the cemetery. I wouldn't feel comfortable going to a cemetery. What would we do after hours? How are we going to get meds there if we needed them? That was my biggest concern and my biggest apprehension.
I received a call one day from my team leader, Deborah Marks, stating that the East team was getting a new patient, and that she says, "I really like you and you know I care about you, but he's homeless and he lives in a cemetery." And my exact words, "You are losing it. I am not going to a cemetery." But then she informed me that he also would go to a car dealership on Patterson Avenue during the daytime.
So I met with Sarah and we kind of devised a plan. What would we do with my team? What would we do after hours? We set up buddy visits initially to make sure that two people go at all times.
I think all team members were a bit reluctant to go into that situation because we didn't know what we were walking into. However, when we got there, it was important for us to understand what his needs were, to try to meet him where he was. I think one important thing to note is that he was homeless by choice. He had a monthly income and could have lived elsewhere, but he made it very clear that he didn't want to follow rules. He didn't want anybody to tell him what to do. There was a certain freedom from living out in the cemetery. So once we were able to understand that and help him understand that we were going to be there for him regardless of what his choice was, it made it easy for him to trust us and allow us to work with him.
So we came up with a plan that on my scheduled days to visit, we would meet at the dealership. And the goal was for him to be there by 9 o'clock. And if he wasn't there by 9 o'clock, I will come to the cemetery looking for him.
The biggest thing that he wanted the team to provide for him was that continued freedom. And so I think that was the biggest thing, that we allowed him to stay out on the streets as long as he possibly could. And I think that was the most important thing for him in the time that he had left.
His pain started to get out of control, and that started to mess with him emotionally and mentally, because I started seeing him being a little more disheveled and not having his stuff together. When I suggested the hospice home, he was more willing to go. Because on that initial visit with Carmen and the chaplain, our goal to him was to make him as comfortable as possible. And if he was not comfortable, to allow us to help him. And he was willing to forego his freedom for comfort.
It made me feel good to know that he was off the street, that he was with us. And my feeling that hospice should be accessible to all citizens, no matter where they are. So I felt good about his being here and that he felt comfortable and that he finally was able to trust us.
The owners of Bel Air Car Rental, they stepped up and really supported Mr. Jeffries in his end days.
Oh yeah, he was part of this company. He'd help us paint, do whatever, eat. We sure eat every day for the last several years. We miss him. We actually got a, out on the side of the road, it hadn't grown yet, we've got a flower bush planted in his honor the day after he died.
So Mr. Jeffers was not our first homeless patient, but it does speak volumes about the collaboration of the agencies and the people in this community. There was a homeless man who was in a cemetery. There were maintenance workers who knew he was there, but allowed him to stay in the bathroom. There was a car rental dealership who allowed him to use their facilities and to give him a little bit of work. There was Novant Hospital who diagnosed his case, did as much as they could, and referred him to hospice and palliative care. And it was at hospice and palliative care that he received the comfort that he needed so that he could go peacefully in his end.
Shortly after Mr. Jeffrey's death, our friends and his at Novant Health invited members of his care team to share what his experience had been like. While Mr. Jeffries is not our only homeless patient, his story demonstrates the wonder that can be accomplished through collaboration, and it exemplifies our unyielding commitment to provide compassionate care to every person in their final chapters.